캘거리는 11월 초임에도 눈이 많이 내린다. 집 앞 눈을 치우지 않으면 벌금을 맞을 수 있기 때문에 호다닥 나와서 눈을 치운다. 딱히 할 게 없었던 나는 나와 나타샤에 대해서 조금 이야기를 해볼까 한다. 안녕하세요 여러분, 성열입니다. 아까 눈 보셨죠? 지금 여기는 그 11월 초밖에 안 됐는데 눈이 너무 많이 내리고 있어요. 그래가지고 뭘 할까 생각하다가 지금 때가 된 것 같아요. 저희가 이제 어떻게 만났는지 말씀을 드리려고 하는데, 처음부터 나타샤 여기 옆에 앉혀두고 시작하기에는 너무 부끄러워가지고 저 혼자 지금 먼저 인트로를 찍고 있어요. 이따가 데리고 와가지고 같이 얘기를 해볼게요. 제가 기억하는 거는 저는 이제 뭐 이렇게 만나가지고 같이 걷다가 웃다가 캐나다까지 와서 결혼하고 이제 애들을 낳고 그런 단편적인 것밖에 기억이 안 나는데요. 나타샤는 이제 아무래도 디테일을 다 잘 기억하고 있을 거예요. 자, 제가 데리고 와서 한번 물어보겠습니다. 안녕하세요. 제가 아까 말씀드린 대로 나타샤를 데려왔습니다. 먼저 시작하기 전에 저희는 되게 막 터칭, emotional, cheesy 하지가 않아가지고 좀 재미가 없을 수도 있지만 그래도 한번 물어보겠습니다. Natasha, is it time
for
to tell them how we met?
How we met, like a full story? Or like, like details?
Some details. So,
oh my god, this is so awkward.
I know, it's really awkward, and then we are not, like, we're not gonna talk about destiny, or like, we fell in love. Oh.
Okay.
That's not our thing. So, where did we meet?
So, after I graduated university in Toronto, or no, I was outside of Toronto, but anyway, after I graduated university, I got a job in my field, but I didn't like it. So I decided to move to Korea in 2012, like 10 years ago. I moved to Korea. That's so weird. And yeah, so I moved to Korea to teach English. And I was teaching English there. And one of my friends from high school was actually already in Korea, Emily. And she had been there for a couple months already, so she had a group of foreign friends, or like, it's so weird saying foreigners because I don't think I'm foreign, but like of people from North America or South Africa and things like that. Non-Koreans. She had a group of non-Korean friends. Anyway, one of those girls organized a pub crawl.
I'll
Do you guys
explain in the
do pub?
subtitle. Don't
Okay.
worry about
Yeah, I don't know if Koreans do pub crawls. I think that's a North American thing. But anyway, she organized a pub crawl in Incheon, in Bukyong, to go to a bunch of different North American bars. And I was one of the only people who like wasn't in a relationship. A lot of my friends there like came to Korea with their boyfriend or girlfriend or something, and so I was one of the only ones that didn't that wasn't in a relationship. And so on this pub crawl, everyone was a little bit drunk, and they dared me to go on a date with a Korean, or they didn't dare me to go on a date with a Korean. They dared me to ask for somebody's phone number because they wanted to know and like hear a story about what it would be like to go on a date with a Korean. So they dared me to get anybody's phone number in the bar that we were at. And Sungil was the bartender. So, yeah. And then after that, I think you messaged me like a few days later and you said that you couldn't talk to me until after your exams were over.
Yeah,
He was such a good student.
I was really busy, actually.
So he like messaged me to tell me that he couldn't talk to me, pretty much. And I was like, okay, cool. Like, what's the point? Why'd you even message me? And then a few weeks later, he messaged me and you asked me to go on a date.
Wasn't actually a date.
It wasn't a date,
Yeah, and then like
but
both of
like
us, I don't
just
know,
hang
at
out.
least for me, I thought it would be just a one-time date because
Do you think you were just showing a foreigner around to a new place?
yeah, because I didn't speak any English. Yeah, it's not a like
He didn't speak English at
yeah
all.
at all.
Like nothing.
I didn't even know what a bus stop was. Yeah, in English. Yeah, Jeongnyujang, right? So
He didn't know how to say bus stop. I remember he was like trying to explain and like look on his phone on like Naver Translate or something and like look up the word for bus stop to like tell me where he was taking me because we were going to a bus stop.
So anyway, that's how we met. It's really boring, but I can't believe our relationship lasted this far because,
Because you didn't speak English at all.
yes, and
And
actually Natasha's contract was done, and then I thought
no, you have
she
to say about our first date. So
okay. Okay, then tell them. I don't even remember, actually.
you took me to Juksam building
Yes.
in Oviedo. So we went to Juksam building. That's what it's called, right? Juksam 63 building.
Yes.
Anyway, we went there and nobody was talking because you couldn't talk and I couldn't speak Korean at all, like nothing. I think I knew how to say like thank you or hi, and because I had just gotten to Korea like a couple months before. So we went to Juksam building and then we went out for Korean fried chicken afterwards, and then I remember it was Sindorim Station in Seoul. We like went our separate ways, and anyways, the next morning after our the first time we like hung out, the next morning I was like going to work and I saw you outside of my apartment building and I thought you were I thought you were some type of stalker, like some creep, because like how the heck did you know where I live? Anyway, he was outside of my apartment building and I was like mortified, so I was like trying to avoid him and we ended up getting on the same bus. Anyway, I went to work and I told my coworkers, I was like, this guy I hung out with last night, he showed up outside of my apartment building this morning. And like, I tried to get them to like research you. And like, they were like telling me Korean words to like ask you questions. But I thought you were like the creepiest person ever because you were outside my building and like Seoul is huge. But anyway, it turns out that you or he went to university like right down the street from my apartment building, so he had to take the same bus that I took to work. He had to take it to school. So it turns out he wasn't as creepy as I thought, thankfully.
I'm actually worried about how I make a subtitles for this. It's really long. I'm scared already. I'm scared already.
Okay. Anyway, so yeah, I thought he was a big creep. And it turns out he just went to school down the street. And yeah, we actually have a picture of the first time of me asking for your phone number at the bar. So we'll show that picture here.
Natasha, she extended her contract.
Yes, I was only supposed to be in Korea for 1 year. But I extended it for another year.
So she came here, and we spent more time together, and then after I graduated, I couldn't get a job, so
And I wanted to come back to Canada.
yes,
I wouldn't say homesick, but homesick, a little bit homesick, I guess.
and I actually came Canada with her because now I could trust our relationship because she actually like came back to Korea again for me, so
That sounds so gross for you. Anyway.
for me, yeah, there's no reason. I came to Canada with her,
And
And I
then, like,
spent more
after
time. So I thought I would go back to Korea, but
we started applying for permanent residency so you could stay longer.
no. Yeah, that is wrong. Because
Why?
like you started,
Oh, while you're in Korea,
yeah.
right.
I don't even know why, because like she was so sure
That I wanted to
that,
stay in Canada.
yeah, but I don't know. Like, so I don't know. She told me like what she needs, so I just brought everything and
Like
then
all the documents. Oh, we
yeah.
even got letters from like the building manager of like the apartment that we
Yeah,
lived in.
so she got me a PR, and I don't know, like I
I didn't
wasn't
just get it. It took an eternity.
eternally, yeah,
They
she
make it sound like I just filled out a form and it came the next day. It literally took like almost a year.
I
I
didn't do anything.
remember
She did it.
I did it all.
Yeah.
He literally, I don't even think you signed your name. I think I signed it for you.
No.
Yeah,
So, yes, yeah. I don't know why, but and then I probably wasn't confident enough to get a job in Korea again. So I stayed there and then working maybe two or three jobs, studying English at night, and then
And
here
here we
we are
are.
right now. Yeah. I know it's a pretty boring video. It's not Tinder or
No,
like,
we'll show some photos at the end
yeah, we
of
will.
like our first years dating. That'll
Yeah,
be.
yes, I will. I will
We
show
look
you.
very, very, very well rested
And
and
young.
young.
Yeah. And then we'll talk about our story life more often through this channel. So thank you.
Bye.
Yeah.
Enjoy our pictures.
Enjoy our pictures. Thank you so much. Bye.